Good evening. Welcome to this unboxing video of Samsung Galaxy S23 phone. You might hear some rain sounds, and it's provided to you by Mother Nature. This video is not sponsored. So, the Galaxy S23 offers the best that Samsung has for 2023 from the Snapdragon 8 Gen 2 to a high-class camera system led by an impressive 50MP sensor. It's just the right size at 6.1-inch display, and it brings you a larger battery than S22. Let's take a look. All of the normal warnings for protective harm, of course, recyclable packaging, all of the trademarks, and quick information about 5G capabilities. Interesting, it looks almost like a part of the box. Was a cardboard. Almost tricked me a little bit. I thought it was indented inside. So here is the phone itself. Here we have a protected surface of the screen. Ready to take off this layer. So it probably is going to be very satisfying. Very nice. that comes with this phone. As always, we get a quick start guide and terms and conditions with some of the device information, installation practices, any questions about your device, about the care, safeguarding this, a little bit of diagnostics, emergency calls, etc. Okay. Then we have our needle for SIM card. And we have a charger cord without the power bank. Am I the only one who's tired of them not supplementing you with the actual power outlet? And now these go to not even to USB. So if you had one before, it's not gonna work. So this is the charger. So you can tell those cameras will be catching everything. So this phone is actually not for me. It will be for my husband because I have my phone and it's S20 that I've unboxed a few years back. And it's working just fine. It's my favorite phone to this day, mostly because of its expandable memory, so he can use SD cards. In all of these newer phones, it's no longer a feature, including S23, which to me personally is a big bummer because I enjoy being able to expand your memory to almost unlimited amount. So, it's beautiful glossy. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to be installing this glass surface protector for the screen. I do enjoy these velvety kind of matte boxes. To remove bubbles. this is a two-pack. I only need to use one. So I shall put the other one to the side. This is going to be our little device holder here. Okay. So first, you need to clean and wipe your device with step number one. We're using a bit of alcohol wipe. Right off a bit. Okay. It was very clean, but now it's definitely cleaner. Okay. We take our easy fit tray. Peeling off this sticker here. What an amazing sound. So then we place our phone down, face up, and we need to place this directly on top. Pretty well. So now you press and slide from the middle out. Just to press down, then down. Okay, let's start. seconds. Pretty sure it's been more than 30 seconds now. Okay, so let's remove from here now. Lift up the top and recycle it. Okay, so now we're removing this screen too, the protective film. An amazing job. I don't see one bubble, not one. Okay, so this was the first time I didn't have bubbles. I must look at this company again. There's lots of tapping in this video, you guys. Okay, now it says to use a squishy, but I truly don't need any. I'll just finish off the sides a little bit. That's it. That's the end, you guys. Oh, that is so pretty. Of course, attached all of the backing while being careful with the other side. see if we can put the case on it, okay? So for the protection for the outer box, we're using this Outer Box Defender Pro, and mostly because my husband wanted to have a clip on it, and he really trusts this brand. So here's the protective case. Of course, chose the black color. Honestly, he will lose it again a million times because it's black color. But just seriously, I got myself a red cover specifically so I can find it. Because anything black just gets lost on most surfaces. But it's his choice. We'll just have to look for his phone more often. So I believe we have to open this part up first. There are some instructions. Okay, so you separate the top and bottom layer. Place your phone in the middle and then attach the top layer. Okay, let's do that. Is there an easy way or is there a hard way? So I'm trying to figure out how to open this. Which part comes off is the question. I don't get it. So I was able to just do this by hand here, just in case you're wondering. That's so weird. Okay. placing the phone inside, putting this on top. Just like so, I'm sure it's gonna click. Okay, and then we'll put the rubber surface protector on the back additionally. So that's what this looks like so far. Nice and brand new. Looking good. What do you think? Alright, I'll be back. Hello, you guys. So it has been pretty much a week since I recorded the last time here. So I just wanted to do that follow-up that I promised and do a little bit of picture quality test. So my husband has been using this phone for about a week now. He also has these Samsung headphones. Little earbuds. Usually I like the sound of headphones kind of rustling, rummaging in the spot. So cool button sounds, right? Just wipe the surface to show you this phone a little bit in action. Okay. Good. Take it off from this case. This does sound pretty good to me personally. Kind of a silicone sound, sounds nice. Okay. Let's take a look. How very appropriate, that's our wedding picture. So I wanted just to go to show you quality of camera. It's probably not going to be the best look. So I'll show you some pictures of plants in my yard, so you can see how good it is. Look how much detail. That is pretty cool. I love the bokeh effect at the end once focused is caught. Beautiful bokeh effect. Some California puppy. Poppy. Gorgeous. Flower. I love watching bees and bumblebees just dive right in. It looks so cute. They get like right inside and just kind of twirl around there. It's pretty adorable. Oop. Here's the video. Look at our beautiful fairy garden. I love the beautiful, again, kind of realistic look of this camera. I'll turn off the sound, guys. Oh gosh. So really awkward. Zoom in very well. Oh my gosh. Look how cute this is. Oh my goodness. And if I look at it from this angle, the quality of camera is definitely amazing. You can really see like inside parts of flowers. I do think that basically the best thing to buy a new phone for is for the camera quality. Oh look, that's me. What are the chances? Oh my gosh, not that one. Okay, let's see. So some of the people I watch right now, I love Sarah Lavender ASMR. She's been probably one of my favorites in the last, well, a couple months, I'd say. And she has a video that's my favorite. Obviously, this is not my account. It's my husband's account, so it's not going to be in here. One I liked. ASMR for 1 hour. I really enjoyed this one. Brighten up the screen if I can. Posting that video, which was triggers while you fall asleep. Yeah, this one. I love this one. It is also one of my favorites. Oh my god, I'd skip the promotion.
Hey mom, let's see. Hello. I mean, I brought a ton of stuff. I brought like a face mask.
So yeah, I did my best to give her credit. In this video, about this video, you actually see my video right here. It's inspired by this video. Personal attention while you're sleeping. Okay, I did my best to give her credit, so I hope you guys got a chance to check her out too. Because it wasn't my idea. But I do enjoy her aura. I love her sweet attitude. There there's just something very calming and comforting and very genuine about her. She has one of those eyes. Let's see her face. That when she smiles, it actually like lights up her whole face, and you can see that it's a genuine smile, so she smiles with her eyes. Oh my gosh, that's not a good one. I love that a lot of her videos are quite simple, but very thoughtful. You can see that she puts a lot of thought into learning more about anxiety and how to help people. Just something magical. I like her stuff a lot. Okay. Who else? I watch a lot of non-ASMR videos as well. Comedian Matteo Lane. Yep, he's my favorite. Oh my gosh, I hope he comes here one time for a show. It's gonna be not very ASMR worthy, but he's so funny. I can't stand it. So anyway, if you guys get a chance, if you haven't heard of him, you should check him out. He's amazing. Okay, then I love Miss Janie. Well, let me just find Blonde Water Repeat. She is a local person who's a gardener, and I actually got to meet her this weekend. She's wonderful. She does a lot of gardening videos for our area.
Hi everyone. It was so beautiful.
So anyway, so that's some of the people that I like to watch. Let me just actually go to my to my subscriptions. Yeah, I love this one. So it's Lynn Cinnamon ASMR. I love her style. She does have like a beautiful setup for lights. I like how she traces everything. And mostly these show and tells of really beautiful things, and I really like that. You don't see a lot of it. It's like really pretty things. Yeah, highly recommend if you enjoy show and tell videos. I adore her. Then I just recently found down this Eternal ASMR. Where is she at? Okay. So, and I've watched, I think, this video, this one, I forgot. They look similar sometimes. And I actually found her when I was looking for a rain stick video, and she has a video with a rain stick that I was looking for, and I really liked her. She was very kind. It's a funny introduction. to me, she has one of those hands. I don't even know how to call them. It's like they're very tactile, so they like have to really press. You know, I try to do those hands all the time because I feel like that's partially ASMR thing, is when you do these kind of like slightly sassy, like almost clammy, I don't know what to call it, hands, when you just like really like do really detailed work with your hands. So I enjoy her videos. I've only, again, just subscribed recently, so I've only watched a few, but I enjoyed them and I actually have subscribed. Let's see. Well, latte ASMR will know. Oh, my sister. How about ASMR sense? I loved this video. I'll skip the trailer. She does a really good job with her setups. She has a very good ear for sounds, to me. She has a lot of role plays with, again, like doctor, spa, hair professionals. She has a wonderful accent that I no longer have. She does everything so delicately, so carefully, and she has very different videos. My niece, Malashink. Her series with paper sorting and kind of unintelligible bookkeeping sounds are quite popular. I'm very happy. She's really good with these kind of, again, sticker typing, paper sorting. She has this slow movement, unrushed, just down. And I love watching these for, again, like when I'm editing and I just need a background noise, or when I'm cooking or doing something that, again, I just don't need anybody actually speaking information to me, but I would like almost like a company sounds that are just pleasant sounds. Some people listen to the sounds of nature. Some listen to sounds of birds or water flowing. Other people enjoy these mundane sounds of every day. I like those too. This one's a very popular video. So yeah, she has a whole series. So if you guys haven't checked it out, this delicate touch. And I do think she has absolutely the most amazing hands in the world. Like, her hands is what I want to have. Okay, I've been enjoying Ida Fox. I'm sure everybody heard of her. I love when she uses long nails. I myself almost never do that, but I really want to. She had this one that I really enjoyed with the hair recently. Which one was it? windows. I love again all the long nails.
Brush again.
Just something about extremely long fake nails for me sometimes just does it. I personally again think that it makes your hands look a little bit more unpredictable. Does it make sense? Like it gives it less comfort. So you do things a bit in a more sassy kind of way. Your pinkies automatically move out and you start doing again things a little bit in a more sassy way. Plus she has a very nice demeanor. Massages, kind of sort of brushing your hair in the background. I like those. Sometimes she does them nice and fast, and sometimes she does them nice and slow. Which I enjoy. I do like when people go from fast to slow. Dimension and movement in the video. See on my phone here more. I love Dasha. Dasha. She does it in Russian though. My husband is gonna have all of these suggestions now. So she does Russian ASMR. And I love it. Feels like an ethereal creature. Beautiful human being. You can tell she's so amazing at this. So I love watching her ASMR. Of course, Osley ASMR. Love her for many years now. Well, at least for a couple years. It's this beautiful young woman with piercing, gentle eyes. Such a blessing she is. I cannot tell. Magical person, truly.
1, 2, 3. ASMR triggers.
So simple. Like the little, I just cannot stand it. But everyone is doing it. So if you notice, I never do that in my videos because I feel like I'm the only person who doesn't like it. But again, it's not on her, it's just on. one of the things that affects everybody's doing it, so it's just become a part of a community. But look at her beautiful, gentle, genuine eyes. She definitely has her own specific style that she does videos. I love when she talks to us. Such a bright aura, such a beautiful person, you can tell. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that this was pleasant.